Edo APC pull Obaseki's 2022 budget proposal. Hello, my amazing family. I am a super fan of affirmation. They help us build self-confidence and push ourselves towards the lofty goals that we envision. Keep saying hashtag I am a light. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. Edo State Chapter of the All Progressive Congress APC Sunday ran down the 2022 budget proposal of Governor Godwin Obaseki, which is submitted to the 10-man State House of Assembly last Wednesday, alleging that it duplicated projects to siphon state funds. A statement by the Assistant State Publicity of the party, Victor Ofori Osehobo, said the budget proposal by the People's Democratic Party, PDP, led government in the state was unrealistic. Obaseki had submitted a budget proposal of 214.2 billion naira, which he tagged Project of Renewal, Hope and Growth. The statement said Obaseki had last year said his government had closed a 25 billion naira 5-year bond at a record price of 9% to fund the 2021 budget, but did not mention the current status of the 25 billion naira bond. He said, on a closer look, the 2022 Obaseki budget proposal is completely unrealistic and duplicitously embellished with impractical predictions, a development that confirms fear by many Edo people that this administration is obviously still trying unsuccessfully to lay a foundation for governance, as Obaseki himself declared 5 years ago. The proposal again illustrates that Governor Godwin Obaseki has perfected the act of wasting Edo State funds on frivolities. How does he explain the allocation of 21 billion naira for government buildings and another 15 billion naira to enhance the work environment? As expected, the Obaseki 2022 estimates is padded, and this can be deduced from such spurious allocations as providing social and youth development, 5 billion naira technology enhancement, 7.6 billion naira effective fiscal and business friendly regulatory policies, 4.5 billion naira. The proposal includes water, which is non-existent and which the government has never attempted to provide anywhere in the state. For 1.2 billion naira, this is as ridiculous as the provision of 1.5 billion naira for citizen reorientation and social protection and 9.2 billion naira for public safety and security, which are suspicious and questionable and calls for answers. The party claimed that the education sector was worse hit with the governor's position that children in primary school in Nigeria now learn 3 times more than they used to learn with the old pedagogue, and that the school has the least number of out of school in the country. He alleged that the governor had no plan of repaying the several loans and bonds. The Obaseki-led PDP government certainly is trying to use its bogus mega program and phantom technology, calm public and civil service reforms, and the creation of an investor-friendly environment in the state as cover and conduit to take loans and cancel repayments. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. The Edo APC
claims that the Mr. Godwin Obaseki's budget is full of deceit and duplication, calculated to inflict more pains on Edo people by allocating funds to projects he claims to have already completed and commissioned. Besides, the party claimed that the governor forgot to mention the current status of the 25 billion naira 5-year bond his administration successfully closed at a record price of 9%, which resources will be available to fund the 2021 budget. On a closer look, the 2022 Obaseki budget proposal is completely unrealistic and a development that confirms fears by many Edo people that this administration is obviously still trying unsuccessfully to lay a foundation for governance, as Obaseki himself declared 5 years ago. We have it on good authority that the government's plan is to postpone repayment of these loans and bonds and leave the future generation of Edo children under the burden of huge debts after his exit. This is ununderstandable considering the fact that Mr. Godwin Obaseki over time promised to climb Mount Everest with bare hands. While we sympathize with the governor, we would however advise Mr. Obaseki to once again involve well-tested hands in the management of the state. Relying on a disabled legislative branch and a cabinet of inexperienced persons has proved counterproductive. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. The progress of Edo State is for all, and as such, due care should be taken to save ourselves from unrealistic and deceptive programs, proposals, and policies, the statement added. You may recall that the governor of Edo State, Godwin Obaseki, left the All Progressive Congress APC to join the PDP in 2020 during his second term bid, which has led the Edo APC to see everything wrong of Obaseki's governance. Thereby, the Edo APC will find faults to discredit his second term in any way possible. Just to paint his image black. Please don't forget to hit on the subscription button for more authentic news. And please don't forget to give us a like, share, and comment. Thanks for staying with us. Bye-bye.